don't write the degree level or particular school degree, and only write what kind of competency I have and what can I do, showing my capability with my experience and evidence. So still, portfolio is very important issues. How can we admit and transfer the credit? So the certificate, especially from national certificate by examination, national examination, we transfer particular type of certificate. We put some amount of credit. For example, the social workers taking the test and national social worker certificate, we admit 30 credit hours, something like that. That's the one thing. And the other example is somebody, I don't know how to express in English, and artwork, and our traditional singer, and calligraphy, traditional Korean culture, and cook, and the recognized national level. If I work like an apprenticeship under those kind of person, I can be transfer some credit hours. So for example, a lady had some recognition nationally to cook Korean traditional food. So I just, yeah, 궁중 음식. I was just hired and as a disciple in her kitchen 2 years, and then she evaluate me and she gave me some credit. So it's not the typical to share with your country, because every country has their uniqueness. In the Cribet, the Cribet, at the beginning, under the caddy, they just responsible how certificate transfer to the credit hours, how many credit hours. So still, they are the responsible organization certificate. They just evaluate some amount of credit hours in each certificate, and they transfer us, and we just use it. That's the Cribet. And let me show others, another things. Oh, no.
Yanghua is really clear from the organization of the institution or the higher education or university. Mm-hmm. It is really clear to keep in the credit bank. And for my, I'm so thinking about other organization, example like the training center or the workforce or like the company.
What's the training center
that provide for training center. Mm-hmm. How do you keep that credit in the bank?
Yeah.
How do you count it? You have an experience on this?
Okay, good questions. I already mentioned, so you didn't listen my lecture. I mentioned the illegible
part.
Who are eligible the register CBS individual, some courses like 3 to 5 courses or institute. So from your customs training center, they save, they collect each student's, each learner's credit. They just collect as a group. And then they come to NIAL and register as an agent of the students. So that's why I mentioned what we need to cautious and watch out. In that case, we cannot control directly individual learners because we trust institute or training center, but we don't know if they decide their mind to lie in credit bank systems. So they just hire students at the field, 1,000 sometimes, 2,000. One case is 8,000 students, and they collect the money, and then, okay, we will handle everything. You cannot only pay the money, and you cannot take the courses. And like this side, sitting like this setting, always click, 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 click. Because for online courses, we made the continuous lecture impossible. So each page must click and taking and then click. So that's the our strategy to taking the lecture by the students. But they hire person and employees just to click, 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 and click. So as an individual, you can visit NIAL. So that's why I asked to the Minister of Education, year 2017 May, we move in new building in Gwanghamun Cheonggyecheon. At the gate of entrance of Cheonggyecheon, we have a big building. At the time, I asked to the Minister of Education, we must be located, the transportation is convenient and near the government because individual learner all around the country from different provincials, they come to NIAL to register their credit. So we must be located convenient transportation nationally. So individual, just by yourself, you can come to NIAL. Or just from the training center, you brought big, huge bag, saving all your students' credit and come to us and registers all the person. So the registration fee in credit bank system is different as an individual or as a group at the institution level. It's a different fee. And also, we are taking some money when we went to evaluate the courses. If they want to, their courses being put credit bank courses, they must be taking our evaluation. So we visited their school and questions and monitor everything. And then we accept or not. So if they got the results, they got the results as a past, after that time, they can collect the students. So it's very big business. And some schools, they open the one course, the students, 1,000 students. It's impossible in general university. So we have some maximum number of students, 200, something like it, even online courses. At the beginning of credit bank systems, all credit courses must taking class directly, face to face. But the participants, potential learner in credit bank degree, they having a job or too old or disseminate all around the country. So it's impossible to ask them come to college classroom. That's why we using accept, admit online. I mentioned male and female toilet separate. Yeah, it's a, it started, I think, year 2000 or, 2002, something like that.
Professor Ki, thank you so much. Now, based on listening to you, I understand that Ministry of Education of Korea designated three organizations to look after CBS in Korea. Of course, CURIS, CRIVIT, and also NIE.
Yeah.
Now, you just mentioned about NIE, and based on my listening, I'm not quite sure this is correct or not, NIE is responsible for courses evaluation and accreditation.
Right.
For all of the say
yes.
teaching departments, including university.
Yeah.
All right. So NIE actually has a big power.
Okay, big power. So the audit department in our government in year 2014 visited our center after big lobby gate. Something from parliament and political person, and I was broadcasted as the president. She will be closely connected to business and industry, something like that. It was a big, very corrupted one. That's not happened in my period. I just started my period 6 weeks later, it burst. It's already happened 4 years ago in my period. And at the time, the audit department from our government and mentioned to me, you are strongly a powerful institute, but Ministry of Education didn't recognize it. If we evaluate and give pass for an organization or training center as a credit bank course, they can promote their course nationally and then collect tuition. It's different university and college. Basically, we have some assumption. At least the college or university will be honest to handle the courses. But a credit bank system operation considered as a cash cow, even in a university. For example, one university, this is higher education, and they have students who are taking college entrance national examination. So they are 19 or 20 years. Under the name of this university, they have a lifelong education institute. They just call it usually And in this building, they offer credit bank system courses. And also, they set cyber university. And it's controlled under Higher Education Act. This controlled Lifelong Education Act. Different law and regulation. So, one university, they treat valuable this part like a higher class who have a higher score and no examination here. It also no examination, but they pay the tuition. They pay the tuition. So they treat those two parts as cash cow. But both two parts served without crowd bank system or cyber university, a cyber college. They must be developed online courses for their own students who are taking college entrance examination, general students. And also, they have 6 to 18 credit hours credit admit from different university. Oh, no, no, 26. Yeah, 26. Different university you can take in the courses or some kind of training centers. The college accept here. So for their general students, they offer various kind of educational courses. But from the business view, just separate, it's commonly used and launched new institute, Cyber University. And here, Lifelong Education Institute. So they have a three different gate collect money. Enough?
Before I was confused a little bit that NAI also has the power to
powerful
universities, but this is not. Mm-hmm. So basically, since you are on different national acts, mm-hmm. NAI is under Lifelong Learning Act,
yes.
Still today,
yeah.
Still under Ministry mm-hmm. of Education. Mm-hmm. So if I use the word customer, NAI will go and evaluate mm-hmm. companies,
yeah.
Colleges,
yes, yes.
Not university.
Yes, we have a, yes, university too. Here, Lifelong Education Institute, under the name, okay, I'm a professor in Sungshil University. We have a Sungshil Cyber University. And also we have a Sungshil Lifelong Education Institute. So, our university president asked me, serve this part or this part? And my response was at the time, okay, president, I know. How have different contents. So when we taking a course name, we can imagine what the students can do after taking the class. But in case of credit bank, that's impossible. At the beginning, we just reviewed their syllabus. It's totally barriers. So that's why we set the standardized curriculum here, like high school and middle school and elementary school. We have a national standardized curriculum in elementary and secondary school.
Mm-hmm. This morning, we discussed among the Thai universities, and it seemed that some universities start to have maybe their own credit bank system. So may I ask, like, in terms of the role of the Ministry of Higher Education, if we also going to have the another national credit bank system, so how it's going to be somehow integrated? And
okay, I don't fully understand what's a particular university have their own credit bank system. I cannot imagine, but in case of our university, we have a Sungshil University, one of strongest program at social welfare, one of the top. The Seoul National University and Sungshil University. In lifelong education, number one is Sungshil University. But for credit bank systems, they have a major social welfare. And the students who don't